of the first album. And I'm excited to hear your stories about how music has affected you and the problems that you were going through. And I used some of those stories to fucking create this album. So thank you for helping me make the Year of the Spider. Here's what I'm saying.
Always on the road with me. Stupid girl, stupid girl, stupid girl.
We missed you very much. Thank you. Thank you for having me. Because she was by herself and she had no car, so there was some kind of way she was getting on the shows and it was disturbing. So I was smoking a cigarette off the trailer one day and I had her come over and tell me her story. And basically what had happened is that her father had abused her very badly, monstrous shit. And she had ran away and she was coming to cult concerts to kind of help her feel better about her situation. It wasn't okay, so I stopped her from coming to the shows. We helped her out for a little while, and I kept in touch with her for about a year. I really hope she's still on the face of this fucking earth. I don't know where she is because I haven't talked to her in many years. She's a beautiful person. This next song I wrote for her, I put a little revenge at the end of it because the motherfucker needed to be dealt with. It's called So Happy.
Let's go!
All right, so years ago, you guys probably heard this on the last one if you were at the show. We were fortunate enough to be on tour with Drake and the show. And Alice in Chains, right when Alice in Chains is in the So, I was a huge fucking Lane Staley fan, man. And I love that man. I remember watching him do jump fan on MTV and going, that's the fucking dude I need to try to see. And so, we were on tour with Jerry, and I go, there were two sold out shows in Seattle. So I kept asking him periodically for the tour if maybe Lane could come to the show. Maybe he could fucking come out here or something. Because Scooter Ward, you know what a fucking. We don't want to see Lane right now. He's not a good place in his life. I go, well, then we're going to get him on fucking fantasy. Because I'm not in a good place in my fucking life. We're going to connect. And he goes, I don't know. So periodically to the tour, I kept asking him if he could do it. And then. The second night of the Seattle shows was how I really liked. So I think Lane felt like he was able to show up at the show in disguise and everything would be okay. So we're standing there, we're doing 13 days of good on stage, Lane's song, and fucking Lane Staley walks up on the side of stage, creeps up, and he's creeping up, and he's got a fucking fisherman jacket on, he's got a hat on, it's a show. Lane Staley's a fucking fisherman. But it was awesome, and he was there, right? And I'll say this, there's been other people throughout the tours that came to that show. There was one show in New York City where Elton John and fucking Ozzy Osbourne were up in the balcony, but it didn't mean anything to me as much as it meant for Lane Staley to be on the show after that show. We had a bottle of Jack Daniels in the back, we went back there, we drank it all, we talked shit all night, and Jerry was right. It was a bittersweet pill for me to fucking, you know, to see. I saw him sit across from me, and I go, this dude is not going to be there. So it was an emotional thing for me. It's been a lot in my life. This next song was written for Lane Staley and Kurt Cobain. The first verse is for Kurt Cobain, the second one is for Lane Staley. It's called The Day Seattle Died.
Yeah!
Thank you very much. You guys doing all right? There's a couple of stories interlaced between this whole set.
I'm all about stories.
This next song, I wanted to take you back to. I know you came here and wanted to hear the fucking songs as they were produced and recorded on Year of the Spider. However, that's not gonna happen. I wanted two songs importantly. I needed to take you back to a moment where the songwriter writes the fucking. Writes the song. That moment where he fucking connects with it and goes, I need to share this with the world, or I don't need to share it with the world. My sister has battled through cancer most of her adult life, for 25 years now. There was a time when we were on this tour, we were in Anaheim, California, and my parents called and said that the chemo had to stop and they had to rush her to emergency surgery to remove 40% of her organs. And when that happened, I'm getting on stage in like an hour and a half, so it was an emotional night for me. The next day in Los Angeles, she was bleeding out. They had to rush her to ICU. So it was a fucking tragic moment for me and my family and everyone. So she's doing better now. She's recovering. When my sister was, the second bout with cancer, it was after Year of the Spider. I had stopped cold for a little bit, and I bought the house where we grew up in. And I put a fucking piano in my sister's bedroom, and I wrote this song for her called Truly Tragedy. We never play this fucking song because it's way too cool for me to sing it, because you still know it through it every fucking day. So it's really hard for me to do it. So there was a moment in 2014 with Cold Live, right, where you guys saw the video of me doing my song, and it looked like it was effortless. We had to edit it twice. I had to stop playing because she was able to be in the back of the auditorium when it was happening, and I couldn't do it. And then she got so sick, she had to leave, and that was the only way I was able to pull that off, and that's why you're seeing that video or whatever. But yeah, it's still a fucking hard song for you to sing, so I appreciate it if you guys sing along with me, because I'm going to break up. Y'all ready? The song's for Jennifer. Thank you. amazing. This one is going to be an easy one.
Yeah. Yeah. Jump!
shot at the people who are fucking coming here. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much for having me. I appreciate you. All right. So, years ago, I did this song called Gone Away, right? It's a problem with this fucking song. Back then, I couldn't hit this one part in the chorus, right? So it was fucked up. The producer kept telling me, Howard Benson, he goes, Scoot, man, you gotta just hit this fucking part. I go, bro, I can't hit that fucking part. That's not what I do. I'm a no-singer dude. And he's like, well, you're gonna fucking hit this part. It's gonna make the song what it is. And he was right. He knows what he's talking about. And that's why he's a fucking big-time producer. So this guy fucking goes, just hit it once, and we'll fucking edit it in. It's gonna be great. And all that bullshit. I go, all right. So it took me 2 fucking hours screaming all this shit. I just go, motherfucker, I quit. And I go, how? And then I thought I hit it in, and then it became what it was, and it was great. Right. So this motherfucker, I go, dude, what if people actually like this fucking song? What happens then? Then I gotta fucking play it every night? There's no way I can say this song every night. I can't, it took me 2 hours and hit one fucking note. So, you know, whatever. So, of course, everybody liked the fucking song, so then all of a sudden, I have to do it on one of these late night TV shows, right? Yeah, whatever. It was the worst fucking experience in my life. I fucking bombed, I sucked. That night, I wasn't cool enough to watch it the next day. I had to watch it that night because I go, oh, this is the end of my fucking career. This is it. This is the end. So, and then I go, motherfucking YouTube. Of course, it's going to be there for the rest of my fucking life, right? And it is. So, there's 5 motherfuckers on there doing this shit. Telling me my mom shouldn't have had me, all this fucking bullshit. And what my mom shouldn't have me.
Okay, I'm back, guys.
So this is what I'm doing. I go, I'm gonna wait till the Year of the Spider anniversary tour, and I'm gonna search the fucking country. I'm gonna find those 5 motherfuckers. And it's gonna be in their fucking career. So this is what we're doing, right? And they said they were Cold fans, Mike, so mind you, they should be in this fucking room right now. Is it you, sir?
Yes!
He said, yes! All right, well, it's 4 now, motherfucker. I'll talk to you after the show. That's what's happening. We're going to chat. All right, so this is what we're doing. There's only been like 9 cities now, or 40-something cities. We're almost at the end of the tour. Thank you for the beauty of the tour, by the way. What we're doing is we're doing the song. I'm gonna sing the first part of the chorus. You guys sing the second part. At the end, the band's gonna fucking judge you guys. And if you fucking fail, I'm coming to y'all's fucking Facebook pages, your YouTube shit. I'm gonna thumbs down. I'm gonna fucking talk shit on your mom, all that shit. Right? This is revenge. However, we were outside smoking a cigarette. I go, I think Flint's gonna win this fucking whole competition. Right? You're the loudest motherfuckers, period. So, and don't think I let everybody win. You can look on YouTube. I fucking thumbs down a lot of motherfuckers. So there you go. All right, y'all ready, Flint? Let's do it.
I'm not afraid to die.
This is the death of my existence right here, because when she says fucking acapella, you know what that means, no music, just me singing and the y'all's down. So yeah, this is how I got in this fucking situation in the first place, is I fucked up, and I'm gonna sing it without any music, which is fucking horrible. So fuck all your phones right now, and everybody pulls their fucking phones out. Alright. That's a good note, though. If she says to fucking hear an acapella, that means you're in the top fucking three, so let's see what happens. Are you ready? Going away, it's the same old song. I think I need to ask him, you motherfuckers were amazing. Thank you very much. That's what is amazing. Thank you. Yeah, they were. Thank you, Flint, for fucking beating every city in the fucking America.
I can't change your innocence.
The morning I was driving down Oade, I go, this is it. I had the gun in the fucking passenger seat. I was going to end my life. And I walked down this long pathway along the beach. It's a long boardwalk kind of thing. The sun was out, everything was great, and then all of a sudden the fucking clouds came in. I don't know if you guys ever see the fucking clouds in Texas or Florida, but when those motherfuckers coming up the ocean, dude, it's like Satan sent them to come get you. It's an ominous fucking scary thing. But that happened. It was a beautiful morning. I started walking down. All I could think about was my daughter. She was just born. I go, I gotta stay here for her. And the other thing that was happening was this fucking piano melody kept playing in my fucking head the whole time I'm walking down. I go, Scooter, Lord, can't even fucking kill himself without hearing a fucking piano song. He's gonna hum into a fucking thing. Might have somebody on there or some shit. So I was like, motherfucker. So I got down to the beach, I got down on my knees, and I fucking stopped. I threw the gun in the ocean. I tried to fucking, I came back, and this record fucking helped me out. It was a pivotal moment in my life. Different Kind of Pain was a huge thing for me. I tried to fucking put the storm that I saw that day on that album cover, but that didn't work because nothing was as ominous as it was that day, right? So this is a song for you. There's a little context for it. It's Different Kind of Pain. We're gonna miss you, Cam. We're gonna miss you.
Yeah.
drumsticks. What, do we not have enough drumsticks? Are we that kind of fucking band? Or do we not know what the fuck's in there? Holy shit. You found one? Oh, shit. Tony's like, no, I didn't find one, but we're gonna make a fucking show. We're gonna get two souls left. So. Because a lot of the stories that you guys tell me and the people that are around me are addicts. addicts or their fucking family's addicts, and things have dealt with that, and this song has helped them. So it's an important song for me, it's an important song for you, so let's all fucking sing it together, and I'm gonna come out there, we're gonna make a fucking circle, I'm gonna get in the middle of it, and then we're gonna fucking make it home. Let's see what we can do. Alright, let's spread it out a little bit. Let's open the circle up a little bit. Because I can, you know, I got moves and shit. I got moves. Fucking moves, you got moves? I don't really have moves. I love you guys so much. Thank y'all for doing this with me, alright? Dance again, live. Makes you think you're everything they ever said you were. Life to take some time. Clear away everything I'm proud. Was enough I'll betray for the shame that I'm in. It's not hard to fail. It's not easy. Flint. Thank you guys. We appreciate you. Love you very much.